there's no mirror on this. I don't know why I'm looking. What is going on in my head? I give up. I just give up. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another episode of Blonde Loves It or Leaves It, where I tell you what I have been loving for the previous month. And I cannot believe that this is for the month of August. I can't believe that summer's over. I feel like it just came and now it's blink of an eye gone. I feel like all I've done all summer was work, which was a little bit of a bummer, but that's life. So I felt like last month was the month I rediscovered my love for makeup. I felt like all summer long, because it was so incredibly hot this summer, I wore very little makeup. I did my hair the same way every single day, which was to just let it air dry because I cannot be bothered with a hot tool or a blow dryer when I am sweating. So I felt like my passion for makeup was kind of put to the side because I just wanted to enjoy summer and be as low maintenance with my appearance as possible. But now that the like colder days are coming and like it's been really rainy and stuff, I've had a lot of inside time, so I've been playing with makeup a lot more. So I do have a lot of favorites for the past month. So this might be a little bit of a long video, but I am doing a little bit of a giveaway at the end of the video. So if you want to see what you will be winning and how you can enter, definitely stay tuned to the end of the video. So let's start off with some skincare products, because I feel like I've been really honing in on good skincare products last month. So the first product is from Derma E. This is a Derma E's Essential Radiance Toner, Glycolic Acid, and Rooibos. Oh my god, I can't even try to pronounce that word. But this is a toner. You guys know I am a huge fan of Derma E skincare because A, it's cruelty-free, and B, it is literally free of everything that you could possibly think of. It's 100% vegan, GMO-free, it's gluten-free, soy-free, recyclable, and it uses wind energy. So it's a really, really good brands because it produces good skincare that's good for you and the environment, which is really important. It smells heavenly. So if you're not a rose scented fan, you might not like this, but I love everything roses. So I really like the smell of this. It's very subtle, it doesn't linger by any means. But this one, because it is more gentle and more natural, it just feels really soothing, really cooling on the skin. The next skincare item is from Botanic Farm, and you guys know I'm a huge fan of their sheet masks. So they sent this out for me for a review, and I've been really enjoying it. I've only tried it out for maybe a week and a half or two, but I really, really liked it so far. This is a cleansing water, so it's very similar to the micellar waters that everybody loves. So I just spritz a couple of sprays onto a cotton pad, and then I'll remove my makeup. Yes, it is a little bit more tedious than just getting a makeup wipe and wiping everything down, but I've noticed that I have a lot less makeup residue after cleaning my face when I use this as opposed to a makeup wipe. So next up is another Derma E product. This is their Illuminating Rose Hip and Cranberry Face Oil. The previous facial oil that I used was from Sunday Riley. It was their Luna oil, that bluish tone oil, which I really like, but I think because I've been using it for a year and a half, my skin has kind of adapted to it and just it doesn't do anything for my skin anymore. So I tried to switch up the oil. I literally just do 2 to 3 drops of this depending on how dry my skin feels after cleansing. And I use this at night. I don't use it under my makeup because I already have oily skin. I do not need another layer of oil to combat throughout the day. So I usually do this as the final step to my nighttime skincare routine, and I really like it. A little bit goes a long way. I just pat it into my skin, especially my under eye. It feels amazingly hydrating under there, and it just brightens up my whole face the next morning. And whatever I have left over, I'll just kind of rub it onto my hands and like my neck and my chest to really moisturize everything else. So those were the three skincare products that really stood out to me last month that I really depended on to help calm and treat my breakouts. So let's move on to the fun parts, which is the makeup, of course. So let's start off with some tools. For some reason, well, not for some reason, I know the exact reason, I have not been using my beauty blender or beauty sponges to apply my foundation. And it is because I am so lazy in the morning that I do not want to go wet my sponge, wring it out, dry it off, all that stuff, just to apply my foundation. Again, I really want it to be low maintenance all summer long. So I've been back to using my brushes for foundation application, and actually really, really miss it. If you've been using a makeup sponge for a while now, switch back to using a fluffy, like, buffing brush, and let me know how it feels, because I really miss these two brushes, and I've missed using foundation brushes on my skin. It just feels really nice. It feels like a nice face massage in the morning when you're buffing your foundation on. So I have been using quite a few different makeup brushes to apply my foundation, but these two were always my favorites. This is from, or they're both from Real Techniques. This is their extra, I cannot speak and I cannot read today. What is going on in my head? This is their expert face brush, and this is their buffing brush. This one is really great if you have a more thicker consistency foundation. Like if I'm using a cream foundation or my Makeup Forever, Or if I'm using my Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation, this is the one that I use because it is a lot denser than most buffing brushes of mine. So it helps spread out the thicker consistency foundation a lot better, and it just blends in really nicely. And then this one is for like more liquid types of foundations. I also really love this for contouring. I have like, I think two or three of these for different purposes. But for foundation, it's really nice. It's nice and big in surface area, so it blends out a bigger surface area a lot quicker. And it's really soft, it's nice and fluffy, it's not too dense, but it does help spread the foundation nice and even around your face. Today I applied the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation with this brush, and it felt so, so nice. So makeup brushes have been my go-to lately for foundation applications. So speaking of the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless, this is the powder from that collection. But because I have been getting a little bit oilier throughout the day, I've been keeping this in my purse for just a quick touch-up throughout the day. It's nice because it is compact, but it does come with a little sponge that actually feels really nice and soft. I'll just lightly push the product onto the sponge, and then there's no mirror on this, I don't know why I'm looking. And then I'll just press it into the places that I get a little bit more oily. So I've been really liking this. It's really lightweight, it helps keeps me matte throughout the day, and it's a great on-the-go touch-up product. So this, A plus. Another face product that I have been loving all month long is the Dose of Colors Desi and Katie highlighter in the shade Fuego. I do have the entire collection and I have reviewed it. It just hasn't gone up on my channel yet, so it might be after this video. But this is one of my favorite products from the entire collection. The shade is really, really beautiful. It's just a beautiful champagne highlighter. If you're looking for a subtle highlighter, this is not going to be it for you. I have it on my nose right now, which I probably just blended away with the powder. So let's just quickly see if I can do this with a big ass fluffy brush. Just highlight my cheeks. I do have it on my face today, and it just looks so beautiful. It's kind of weird to describe. It looks natural on your cheeks, but you definitely see that there's highlighter on there. Next up, we have this Oopsie Proof Liner Eraser from the brand Hard Candy. And this is such a genius product. I know I've mentioned this in a previous favorites before, I can't remember what month, but I've been pulling it out again because, again, I've been wearing a little bit more makeup, so I've been getting into a liquid eyeliner again. Today is like the first day I've worn a liquid winged liner in maybe a month or two. But if you're someone like me who isn't a master at winging out your liner and kind of mess up on the edge, definitely pick this up because this is a godsend. It's literally a felt tip eyeliner with a little bit of makeup remover at the tip of it. So it just helps like wipe away the mistake if your wing isn't pointy enough. It's just a really quick fix without messing up your entire eye look and starting all over. So this has been really handy just to clean up the edges of my wing as well as making my points a little bit sharper. It's just a really smart, smart product, and I'm surprised no one's really talked about it. But I really love this product. This is probably my second tube of it. I always carry it when I am traveling somewhere because Lord knows doing your wing liner in a hotel room with that crappy lighting is nearly impossible. So this always comes in handy. Next up is another product that I've mentioned before. This is the NYX Micro Brow Pencil. It just really makes my brows bold and sharp and defined without making them look too dark or too fake or looking like permanent marker eyebrows. I just really love this brow pencil. It's definitely comparable to the Anastasia brow pencil for a fraction of the price. And my shade is in ash brown and it fits me perfectly right now with this ombre hair. Another eye product that I have been enjoying is the Duo Brush-On Adhesive with Vitamins. I've used Brush-On lash glue before and I've absolutely hated them because after like a week or two, it would start gunking up around the packaging and it's incredibly hard to get a nice application on your lash line because it just starts to get thick and sticky and messy. But this one is really, really liquidy. Like if I shake it, I can hear the liquid inside. Because it is so thin in consistency, it makes it really easy to apply the thinnest layer of glue onto your lash line, which just helps make applying your lashes a lot easier because there's not a lot of glue to fuss around with and to get messy on your eye look. So last month's lip combo is the one that I'm wearing right now. It's just a very natural looking kind of like peachy brown nude color that's not too brown and not too nude. I just really like it and it looks really, really natural. So I line my entire lip with the Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in the color All Natural 04. This is a really pretty mid-tone pinky nude color. So I just take this and start off by lining the outer edges of my lip, kind of slightly lining out of my lip line to help my lips look a little bit fuller. And then on top of that, I apply the MAKE Makeup Lipstick in the color Nude. I got this at Gen Beauty New York last year, I believe. This is a peachy nude. It has a lot of warm undertones to it. And I know these colors don't look right next to each other swatched out like this, but if you blend it out, it just darkens the lipstick a little bit and lightens the lip liner for a really nice, cool, warm, like neutral balance on your lips. So the next product isn't something that I've mentioned on my channel before because I've been trying to just play with it and mess around with it before really deciding if I love it or not. And it is the Jaclyn Hill and Morphe palette. I finally got this during the second release of it. And guys, I am absolutely in love with this baby. It is so perfectly balanced in warm tones, cool tones, bright colors, neutrals, mattes, and shimmers. It's honestly one of the best palettes that's come out in a really, really long time. And I think she did an incredible job with choosing the shades, the formulations, the textures and finishes of each shade. It's just so well thought out that it's just an incredible, incredible palette. There's just so many combinations of colors and different looks that you can come up with that I don't know which one I want to film first, but definitely keep an eye out for a makeup tutorial using this palette on my channel soon. That was all of the makeup products that I have been loving last month. Let's quickly get into some hair care products that I've been really enjoying, and then we can get into the giveaway. So all of these hair care products are from the brand Lange Hair. And honestly, I've never really heard of them before until they reached out to me to send out some products that they think I might enjoy. So these three products are from their hair care line. The first is their Salt and Sea Texturizing Spray. This is with kelp extract and sea salt infused for volume and texture. Anytime that I'm curling my hair, like today, I'll do a couple spritzes of this on either side just to add a little bit of volume and texture to my hair without having to use hairspray. I don't like the way it makes my hair feel. It just weighs it down. It makes it feel crispy and crunchy. It smells weird. It's bad for the environment. I just hate everything about hairspray. So this is a really nice alternative to getting my curls to look a little bit more defined, but also messy, if that makes sense. So if you're going for like a beachy hair look, this is the product for you. I've also really liked their Rival Heat Shield. I've been using this every time I blow dry my hair or curl my hair. So this is keratin infused and it also has chamomile extract and it also locks out humidity, which is great for the summer months. And then last up, we have the Lange Hair Luster Spray Laminate. This has jojoba seed oil and vitamin E infused. It's also UV protecting and shine, soften, and protects your hair. This is really amazing, but just a cautious warning, use very, very little of it. So it's nice to have something like this to kind of bring back that shine without adding too much oil or weight to my hair. So I've really been loving all three products. And finally, for my last favorite for last month, it is the Longe Hair Ondulé 32mm Curling Wand. I put mine back to make it look nice and pretty. But this is the curling wand that I used in my last video when I did a completely Get Ready With Me video and I curled my hair. It's what I used today to get these curls. So this curling wand with that low heat setting really helps me achieve loose curls that holds throughout the day, that doesn't look too uniformed, and it just looks really natural. So I really like this. So this is actually what I'm going to be giving away in this video. I have one for myself and then one for you guys. Longe Hair did send this to me, so thank you for helping me with this giveaway. So this brand new one, it is still wrapped up in the plastic wrap in here. You're not getting the one that I used. This is a brand new one. It's for you guys just to say thank you for all of your support and just for sticking in there with me as my channel has been a little bit inconsistent with my work schedule lately. So this is just a thank you to you all for all your support, your love, and just all your sweet, sweet comments every single time I post a video. So the rules to this giveaway are super, super easy. Just be subscribed to my YouTube channel, which is this one, and also just follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. Snapchat is where I will be announcing the winner. So I'll have this giveaway open internationally. I will ship it anywhere in the world to whoever will win it. So today is September 1st. I will have this giveaway open for 2 weeks so that everyone can get a fair chance at entering. So I will announce the winner on September 15th, which is 2 Fridays from now, on my Snapchat. So please follow me on Snapchat if you want to know if you won or not. If you want another chance to enter this giveaway, leave me a comment down below telling me what your favorite beauty products all summer long has been, and I will enter your name twice into the giveaway. That's it for the rules to the giveaway, guys. Good luck to everyone that is entering. Again, thank you for all your support. I hope you enjoyed this video. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys. That is how I get these messy, beachy curls that you guys are always asking about. So moving on to the outfit of the day, I kept it pretty casual for this lunch date. I just threw on a pair of nude booties because I'm 4'11 and like to be a little bit higher off the ground.